Three, two, one.
Welcome to Eurocycles of Daytona. Daytona Bike Week 2023.
We supposed to be doing something right now?
Vlogging. Just whatever. Just
No, we're not talking. We're just walking to the truck.
Yeah, this is like a vlog style video. The trip to pick up the bike. So there may be video of you eating potato chips on YouTube. But some of the things you can talk about, Lance, is like when we get in here, tell them like what we're going to do and what we're going to pick up.
Okay, we're on our way to Daytona Motor Speedway. We're going to pick up some special motorcycles. We've got some cool stuff going on at the dealership here later today. We got PJ Jacobson from the Revit crew. We've got a couple of Revit brand ambassadors. We have Brandon Posh. May have heard of her. she's won two Daytona 200 races. No, I'm kidding. Brandon Posh, he has won two Daytona 200 races.
If he wins it again
this year, he'll be the only rider ever to win three in a row. So, pretty special evening going on here at Eurocycles of Daytona. If you missed it, you missed out.
Here's our Triumph demo crew.
They doubled up on a Honda Grom.
Yeah.
What do we have going on there?
Daytona International Speedway. We have arrived, picking up some Hot Wheels.
One of the first ones in the United States, right?
That is correct. In fact, it's the only one in the United States right now. How you doing, sir? Hey. We're here to collect some motorcycles from the pits.
You know where to go?
No.
Okay. Take a left and go down to the blue canopy. They'll direct you to the infield.
Thank you, sir.
Glad you made it.
Thanks.
What did he say about filming?
No, he didn't say anything about filming.
I thought he said film.
No. He said, make a lift.
You know where you're going.
Do you know where you're going? No.
We got a little beauty.
How many states has this bike been into, and how many miles are on the bike?
It's made it here all the way from Portland, Oregon. And we are now in Daytona Beach. I don't even know how many states there are in between. How many? Oh, it's actually, what's 3,800 miles from Portland to Atlanta. I don't know. A lot? There's only 3 miles on the bike. So it hasn't been ridden across country, but it's made its way here. It's come out really good. We're gonna need to do some smoky rolling burnouts on this thing. See if we can wheelie it. I doubt that's gonna happen though. Oh.
tell people what we just got in?
We just got one of only two M1000 single R's in the country. We managed to get Nate Kern's bike for display purposes for tonight. It's an absolutely amazing motorcycle, so if you have not seen one, you have to see one in the flesh. It looks way better in the flesh than any of the pictures or anything does it any justice. Has so much carbon bits on it. Nice. Everything that is M related has every belt.
I like this M is inside the lens on the headlight.
The carbon winglets. Aesthetically, this bike is even more pleasing to the eye in person than any pictures do it any justice. So, yeah, I want to ride one. I want to smoke some tires on one, do some wheelies on one, maybe a couple stand-up wheelies, some stoppies, like full-on goon riding on one of these things. Hey everyone, I just want to say thank you to Brandon Posh for coming out to Eurocycles of Daytona. It's been a real pleasure having him here. As you can see, two Rolex watches. This weekend, by the time you guys have seen this video, he'll more than likely have three of those. We're gonna be trying to guess where he's gonna fit the third one. So when you see this and he's won the third watch, let us know in our comments where you think he should hang the third timepiece. He'll be the first person ever to win three Daytona 200s in a row. So Brandon, thank you very, very much.
Thank you. Thanks to the Eurocycles team for having me out. It's been a pleasure coming out here, having some tacos, hanging out with the boys, and just chatting it up, getting ready to go racing, and yeah. Should be sweet, looking forward to it.
You're gonna try to keep the South Africans off your back this weekend?
Yeah, there's a couple of them out there. They're quick, man. And they're little guys as well. So around Daytona, it definitely helps them out. But yeah, we're gonna do our best and try and put the thing on the top again like we did last year. And hopefully we can make it happen.
Well, there you go, guys. Once again, Brandon Posh, best thing to happen to Triumph in years. So we're hoping for a three-peat of the Daytona 200.
Do good the luck. Triple on the
do,
triple, baby.
Do the triple on the triple, that's it.
Lance, where are we going?
We're going to the best kept secret, apparently. We've been eating tacos and quesadillas and all that stuff every day since we've been here. So we're gonna try something a little different, some local cuisine. There's a guy who we usually see on our way in when we're driving in. He's got this cool barbecue spot that's on the side of the road. Bunch of motorhomes there. So we're gonna go and get a mouthful or a belly full of some of the local delicacy barbecue. Looking forward to it. That's the first thing I looked at.
Good, how are you, man?
Appreciate y'all for coming.
Yeah, absolutely.
I saw him taking a picture.
Thank you, man.
Okay, you're welcome. Thank you.
Thank you.
What did we get?
Some combo deals, ribs and chicken. And pork chops, mac and cheese. First up is pork chop.
Show them the ribs. Let's show them that.
We're at the Daytona 200. It's the Battle of the Hooligans class racing right now. Indians are pretty dominant, but Nate Kern's trying to, you know, fly that BMW flag on the R9T. So yeah, it's a pretty tight battle between the top three, right? And as you can see, the guys are just running away with it. Nate's doing well to hold on to top five position.
He's coming up right now, right?
He's coming up right now.
Where are we at? What are we doing now?
What are we doing?
How was the result of the race? How'd Nate do?
Nate did an incredible job. I must say, for him being, I think he's like 15 kilometers an hour down, or 15 miles an hour down on top speed. He's done an absolutely excellent job. He's the only R9T in the field, and you know what he's trying to achieve with that bike in this category, just running at it solo, you know, no assistance whatsoever from, you know, any BMW factory technicians or anything like that. He's done a really cool job. I'm going to show you some bits and pieces of the things that he's done with his bike. He's obviously, you know, put some Ohlins suspension, an Ohlins front end on the bike. They've done some engine work to it. He's been, you know, experimenting with various things and how to improve the bike. He's got BST carbon wheels out of South Africa, by the way.
At the flat track venue, Ohlins, don't miss that. Congratulations to this guy.
He's definitely raised the seat height of the bike a little, just to give it a little more flickability. But you know, these boxer motorbikes they don't have the top speed that all the rest of the manufacturers have. And those guys are throwing heaps of money at it, you know, just to prove a point. But I think Nate's proving an even bigger point by just achieving what he's achieving on the R9T BMW.
What's the next race we're looking forward to?
The Daytona 200. That's the main race. Wish I was in it so I could win a watch. So we're sitting down here in the infield of where the fan zone is, in front of the big screen TV. We're waiting for the start of the 200 race. We've got Ducati Warhorse on the front row of the grid with Josh Heron. A man that we're rooting for is either Ducati or Triumph. Personally, my South African boys should be up there, but we'll see what happens towards the end of the race. It's going to be an interesting race. Wind is blowing. I hope the guys know how to watch the flags for whichever turn they're coming off of, but the race is going to be a long race, so it's going to be a war of attrition for everybody. So one thing we got to look out for is pit stops and making sure that our team guys are going.